Namaste. Today I'm going to talk about a very important spiritual quality which is called focus. Now many people are getting distracted when they do a particular spiritual practice. You don't go deep into a spiritual practice to get its reward. Now many people are very superficial. They try to move from one guru to another, one master to another, one book to another. It is okay to taste from different places, but you need to settle down and find out whatever is your calling across. So this is a very, very important quality as far as this spiritual life is concerned. Now many people think they are very spiritual because they have a guru, they listen to the discourse, and that they have an understanding across. Please understand, practice is very, very important. If you don't practice, your spiritual life is not going to take off. Practice is 80%, 20% is what is theory about. In practice, it should lead to compassion and kindness and understanding and experience. So the most important problem with many people is they lack focus. They are not very clear with what they want with their spiritual life. They say, I want enlightenment, I want this, I want that. But the main problem is not that. The main problem is focus. Imagine a guy who has 10 subjects to study, but who is always telling, I want to get first rank, I want to get first rank. No, it's not going to work. So the point is, have a focus and have a repeated practice into your spiritual life across. That is what Patanjali talks about it as abhyasa. If you want to be successful in your spiritual life, you need to practice. And for the practice, you need to have focus. Whether you are doing 4 times Sandhya Vandana, whether you are doing 3 times Avabhasana, whether you are doing yoga, whether you are doing pranayama, whether you are doing Sufi dancing, do one. Choose one. Don't try to run behind too many options into your life. That is what Jalaluddin Rumi says very beautifully. I try to dug everywhere and I did not find the water. I dug deep in one hole and I found the water. Every spiritual technique ultimately will lead to God. That is why it is being practiced across. The problem with many people is they lack focus, they lack consistency. It is like a weight loss program. So, if you want to grow big, if you want to grow successful into your spiritual life, you need a tremendous amount of focus. Focus is all that will make your life very, very successful. It does not really matter whether what guru you follow. You can have multiple gurus. You can take everyone as an inspiration. You can take Vallalar as an inspiration, Kabir as an inspiration. You can take Francis of Assisi as an inspiration. It does not really matter. What really matters is about focus. You sit down and do in your prayer mat your practice. If you are not doing that thing, you have to ask yourself, are you serious about your spiritual life across? Now, many people are not serious about their spiritual life because they think family life is very, very different from that of the spiritual life. Wrong. Your family life is directly, intrinsically connected with your spiritual life. Your son's education can be taken as a spiritual challenge. Your daughter's marriage can be taken as a spiritual challenge. And your somebody's health can be taken as a spiritual challenge. You can also work in the higher level, like that of the country or a state, or in terms of economics, or in terms of commerce, or in terms of health, all that thing. The problem with many people is they do not associate all these things and they call it as karma kand. No, karma kand is a very important place to practice loving kindness. So don't try to treat your family life, your personal problem very different from this spiritual life. So that is how you will get your focus. The first thing is to accept the problem and to resolve it and use a prayer to resolve it across as a person. I met a saint. I asked him, how do you know for sure you will get food? He said, I pray. Sometimes I don't get food. I pray to God to give me the food. So that is the power of prayer. So the point is, prayer should have a purpose. Either it could be your family life, either it could be your personal life, somebody's health, somebody's wealth, somebody's success, somebody's growth. Definitely you should take it as a thing to do it across. This is actually a women's spirituality which is very, very beautiful, which is very meaningful. Many people try to go run away into the ashram. They try to run away and all that thing. That is a swimming pool. That pool will never disturb you across. Now, to come across into the ocean, to wade across into the ocean, you need to have practice. So remember, your spiritual practice is very, very important. After the practice, dedicate that merit to your family, dedicate that merit to your wife, dedicate that merit to your children. Maybe they have some health issue, they have some family issue, they have something across. So remember to pray for others. Praying for others will give you a lot of focus. Praying for others will give you a lot of success in spiritual life across. I saw a video of a Tibetan monk who was there and was sat inside a place and she has prayed across. So they asked her, "Can you tell us how do you pray?" She said, "May all beings be free of all suffering. That is my prayer across." So in that similar manner, if you pray across, you will not get mentally disturbed across. May all the people in my family be happy, peaceful, and be loving and kind. May they not think about negativity across. Then you go into a different state. You go into a different realm. You don't have money, then maybe you should pray for money across. What is wrong? People say, "No, money you should not pray. You should only pray for jnana." No, you have not come to that level of maturity. You have not come to the level of the university. Why don't you take small challenges before you enter Wimbledon? Why don't you take small challenges before you come to that level? This is forgotten by many people. Many people think spirituality, "I want to take sannyas, I want to renounce life." It's all big talk because you don't have a focus. Myself, my friend Karthik, we went to Thiruvannamalai and we wanted to meditate across. The first day we meditated, we got bored. After that, we want to come correctly in the lunchtime and eat. After a period of time, we could not sit consistently across a person. I realized the biggest problem is not Ramanasaram, or biggest problem is not others. The biggest problem is me. I cannot sit. I cannot be peaceful. I cannot be fully what you call in there and try to do that because I don't have an objective. I don't have a what you call it as an aim. The aim in spirituality can be material life. That is nothing wrong. Now, many people try to talk about material life is not needed. No, it is needed. Money is not the evil. The greed is the root of the evil. If you try to be greedy, if you try to hold money, you don't try to give it to people, you give the belly of other people's even, that is the problem across. So it is not the money or the fame or the power which is the problem. It is your mind. The mind is filled with greed and hatred and anger. Every situation will become a problem. So the enemy is not outside, the enemy is inside. So don't talk about big concepts and don't talk about big things across. It is for a limited few. It is like telling, "I want to be a billionaire." How many people become billionaire after reading books? How many people become millionaires after reading the books? They don't become. Actually, they become more successful than what they are. They become more successful than their family lineage across. In a similar way, you can become more spiritually advanced by praying for others, by praying for other people's welfare. It could be your family across. So therefore, this is a very, very important attitude into your spiritual life across. So don't get carried away in talking about big high-fly stuff. "Oh, I want to get enlightened. I want to renounce the life." You cannot renounce the life because you don't love this life. What you love will never stay with you. What you hate will always stay with you. That's why Gautam the Buddha, before he got enlightened, he wants to leave his house. His father is asking, "Why do you want to leave the house, Siddhartha?" He says, "All people are suffering. All people are filled with ignorance and delusion. I want to help them, daddy. So please allow me to go in search of the truth. I wanted to find the elixir of happiness." Do come it across on that. So in the similar way, many people don't have the attitude of bodhicitta, attitude of loving kindness. So first develop that. Have small steps, have small goals, then you would be able to win over the battle of the ultimate delusion of life. The life itself is real. Brahma Satya Jagan Mithya, it does not happen to anyone. It takes time to happen. It takes practice to happen. So take small steps, then you can grow into a bigger life. I wish you all the best for your spiritual life. May all of you get enlightened. May all of you be filled with divine peace. Thank you.